Hello, in this problem we are going to find the exact value of the sine of pi over 12. So to do this, we're going to write pi over 12 as a difference of two angles that we're more familiar with. In particular, if you have pi over 12, you can write it as 4 pi over 12 minus 3 pi over 12. And this is really convenient because we actually know what these angles are. 4 goes into 12 three times, so this is actually going to be pi over 3. And 3 goes into 12 four times, so this is actually going to be pi over 4. So in problems like this, that's the general idea. You want to figure out how you can write this angle as a sum or difference of two other angles. And then we can use an identity. So I'm going to go ahead and write down the identity we're going to use, which, since we have a minus sign, it will be the difference identity for sine, which tells us that the sine of x minus y is equal to sine x cosine y, and then you keep the sign and you switch the functions, so cosine x sine y. Okay, so now we can go ahead and work out our problem. So in our problem, we have the sine of pi over 12. So we have sine of pi over 12. And that's the same thing as the sine. And we said we wrote it as pi over 3 minus pi over 4. So pi over 3 minus pi over 4. And so now you can see that x is going to be pi over 3, and y is going to be pi over 4. Now you just carefully plug everything in, so this is the sine of pi over 3. And we have cosine of pi over 4, minus, and then cosine pi over 3, sine pi over 4. It's a lot to write. It's really easy to mess up. So let's just double check our work here to make sure everything is okay. So x is pi over 3 and y is pi over 4. There's x, there's y, there's x, there's y. So everything looks okay. X and x, yep, y and y. Okay, so now we just have to work these out. And this is purely from memory. So sine of pi over 12. You definitely want to have these memorized. The sine of pi over 3 is the square root of 3 over 2. It's one you definitely want to have memorized. And cosine of pi over 4 is square root of 2 over 2. Also something you definitely want to know. This one's easier though, because sine of pi over 4 is also the same thing. Minus cosine of pi over 3, it's going to be 1 half. And then sine of pi over 4 is square root of 2 over 2. We should keep going. We can multiply these square roots straight across. Square root of 3 times square root of 2, so 3 times 2 is 6. We get the square root of 6 over 4, minus 1 times the square root of 2 is the square root of 2, and then 2 times 2 is 4. So we're subtracting two fractions, and we have the same denominator, so we can combine these into a single fraction. This is the square root of 6 minus the square root of 2. It's all being divided by 4. And so that would be the final answer. Good luck.